Thanks so much for listening. We hope you enjoyed this message brought to you by Friday Night Light Ministries. For more information, check us out on the web at fridaynightlight.us.
Since it is only the third hour of the day, but it is what was uttered through the prophet Joel. Peter knew the prophet Joel. He's addressing the people, just like you might be out here right now, and he's saying, these are not drunk like you suppose. People acting like drunk men, the 11. And the prophet Joel said, and in the last days, it shall be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. How many of you are prophesying? Raise your hand. I want to see it. How many of you prophesy? Raise your hand up high. You don't need to be ashamed. The prophet and the apostle, they're part of the fivefold ministry. They're there for us. We need them.
Yeah.
Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. And your young men shall see visions. How many of you have seen visions? Raise your hand high. How many of you have seen visions? You should be seeing visions. You should be seeing visions. And if you're older, and you're asking, he says your old men will dream dreams. Old men, old women, you can still have visions too. I really believe that. But if you're older, I believe you should be having visions and dreaming. If you were young and you never had a vision, you should have. In those those days I'll pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy, and I will show wonders in the heavens above, and signs on the earth below, blood, fire, vapor, smoke. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the day of the Lord comes, the great and magnificent day. But Jesus is coming back. Yeah. And it shall come to pass that everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You are the generation. You are those who are leading this charge. God has called us forth. He's raising us up. You should be having visions. I felt it lay in my heart to share that scripture and to share this. We were in a staff meeting, FNL. We were doing worship, and I had a vision. And while I was having that vision, I was also aware of the staff meeting. But I was seen in the spirit. I was taken there. It was as real as we're sitting here. Father God was on the throne. Jesus was down there with him. It was a great bowl, like a valley. I can't tell you how big it was. I don't know if there's a place on the earth like this. It was so wide. It was filled with people all the way around it. Like mountains all the way around. God was down there in the center. All the people that are there in heaven. And I was aware that this was happening at that moment. It wasn't like when we get to heaven. This was happening. And we, doing worship in the house in there, in our staff, we were part of what was happening right then at that moment of everyone worshiping God. And I was aware that there were other people, other places on the earth right at that moment that were also entering in to be able to see the worship that was going on around the throne on earth and in heaven. Do you understand that right now in heaven that is happening right now? We here on this earth right now are joining in with all of heaven to worship God. And I'm going to tell you, they were worshiping God. They were worshiping God. They were dancing. It was amazing. And as we were there worshiping God, some men turned and looked at me, and they were apostles. I was very well aware. And if anyone doubts, then you doubt the word of God. I know what I saw. He said, you shall have visions. How many of you are wanting to go from today to greater? To have visions. To be empowered. To have the anointing of God over your life. To be leading people to the Lord. To be changing and affecting a change. A transformational, lasting change in your workplace. In your families. Everywhere you go, everywhere your feet would fall, that you have victory, that you're taking the kingdom of God across the earth. I believe that God wants to, they're calling to activate. I'm using that word because I really believe some of us are activated, but God's wanting to raise up a new generation. Young, old, millennials, it doesn't matter. If you're not dead, you're part of that group. And he's wanting to raise us up. And he's calling us out. Some of you know that in your heart that he's calling you out. God laid on the heart. Romano's supposed to speak. And God's giving him something to speak. Okay? And at the end of that, I'm going to finish what I'm going to do. I'll just turn it over to you now, is what he said.
It's not going to be long, but I just kind of feel, let's all stand if you're capable. So I want everyone to stand and be engaged and be focused. Because tonight's a real night, because Jesus is in the room, you know? And Jesus is here. He's in this moment. We don't want to miss a moment with God. It's not about what I can say. It's not about what I can say. It's not about a ministry. It's not about a platform. It's about Jesus. The real, raw presence of God that shifts cultures, that shifts the atmosphere, that shifts everything. It's not about what we can say or what we can do, but it's about a real encounter with the love of Jesus, that we can go and see our workplaces change, that you can go and see people change, see people set free. I keep feeling like it's not about me. It's not about what the person up here says.
Right.
You know, it's not about that. It's about you.
That's right.
It's about you. It's about everyday empowered believers preaching the gospel in their workplaces, preaching the gospel in every single area of life, you know? And I just really feel like, man, what would it look like a year from today if we went out and said, you know what, I'm kind of done with not preaching the gospel. I'm kind of done with standing still and just letting the person up there lecture to me and then going to my workplace and doing nothing with what I encountered here tonight. And I just really feel like for you specifically, if this is hitting your heart, I want you to know that God is calling you today to go back to your workplace tomorrow or Monday or whenever you go back to work, but to really reach that person that you hate, to reach that person that you feel like you can't reach, that you feel like is going the wrong way. It's like all of us, it's for all of us, it's for me too. Like, what if I just keep passing the homeless person by without telling him the gospel? What if I keep passing that person by without sharing the love of Jesus? What if I keep passing that person by? No, that person is going to hell. We can't afford that. We're trying to populate heaven and depopulate hell and really see a family birth in freedom. It's about family. It's about relationship with God and relationship with people. And what if we really believed that we could see a whole movement in Michigan, not for our name's sake, not for Friday Night Light's sake, but for Jesus' sake. Could it be that Jesus is starting a movement here tonight? Could it be that Jesus is doing something, that it's no coincidence that we are here today? That he's calling you and saying, no, look, I want you to go. I want to fill you with a power. I want to fill you with a fire. Like the upper room. It's funny because we were praying. And I really felt like God, it's exactly what he shared. That God was opening up the heavens. And that there was something coming down from the heavens. And it was the anointing of the Lord. And the Lord is anointing you today to go preach the gospel. To go see the lost sick. To go see people healed. To go see people set free. But not for your name's sake. It's not for our name's sake. Because at the end of the day, when we die, when we go to heaven, he gets our crowns. It's not about it's not for us. It's not for a little shake. It's not for a little shimmy on the floor where you can dance and stuff like that. But no, it's when you get filled with the glory, it goes out there. People see you. People see you and they're like, there's something different about that person. There's something different about that guy. So I just really want to pray this out. So I want you all to repeat after me. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
I repent. For passivity.
For not
sharing the gospel. It's disobedience. Because you have called us to go. Just like you said, Jesus. And so
right now.
We receive your mercy.
Can I have that?
Yes. Okay, done are the days that we go to things like this, that we go to churches. I know that everybody in here is from different backgrounds, from different denominations, but you're here because you're hungry.
Yeah.
You're here for a specific reason. Am I right?
Yeah.
Is that speaking to anybody?
Yeah.
Pretty much everybody in this room tonight knows of the Lord, at least, you know. We just came from this giant 50,000 person gathering called Ascend. You may have heard it, you may have seen videos. YouTube it if you haven't, it's amazing. Don't listen to the liars and the haters, because there's a lot of hate videos. But the glory broke out. It was literally, people have been asking me, how was it? It was a page out of the Bible. It was literally a page out of the Bible. People were directing clouds like they were traffic on a Sunday. It was crazy. Like, rain was happening when they would say rain. It was insane. People were walking out of wheelchairs. People were being healed. People were being set free. There's people that struggled with cutting and depression and anxiety and stuff and suicidal attempts. That their scars were literally disappearing. It's crazy. And so, I'm sorry if I seem a little crazy, but I refuse to walk away from that without being changed for the rest of my life, literally forever, because it was freaking crazy. So. But it wasn't about a moment. It wasn't about a giant event. People were being encountered that were just watching videos. They're still being encountered. Go watch one of the sermons. Hey, who knows what'll happen. But literally, done are the days that we come to things like this, that we go to church to receive assignments. Like we're working a 9-to-5,
right,
for God. It was literally like Mondo said. It was the last thing that God said. Like before Jesus left the earth. His last thing. You know, it's like you see movies. It's like, you know, any last words. It was literally his last words were to go into all the world and preach the gospel to everyone. That wasn't go into all the world if you have a preaching gift and talk about me. That wasn't go into all the world if you're a prophet or you believe that you're a prophet. I believe I've been reading No Compromise by Melody Green. It's a biography of Keith Green. Highly recommend it. Changed my life. But Keith words it like this. He says, a lot of people have told me that I'm a prophet, but God hasn't said it. I haven't asked God. But I believe everyone's a prophet, because that's what it says in the Bible. The verse that he read, it's literally in there. Everybody can prophesy. Everybody can see visions. Everybody can dream dreams. If you don't, ask for it. Literally. The Lord speaks to me in many different ways. He speaks to everybody in many different ways, in many different seasons. But the primary way the Lord speaks to me is through dreams. Lexi knows. She's interpreted most of them. But the Lord speaks to me through dreams very commonly. But that all started because I thought it was cool. I read it in the Bible. I thought it was cool. And I asked the Lord.
Yeah.
I said, God, can I have some dreams like that? You know, can I see some stuff like that when I'm sleeping or when I'm praying? You know, and it was that simple. You have the ability to pray the things that are in the Bible and receive them. No matter what age, no matter what denomination, no matter where you're from, no matter who you are, no matter what color you are, no matter what you believe, the Bible is the truth. And if we ask for it, we receive. The Bible says in, the Bible says, Matthew 7, this has been hitting me. Matthew 7. The Bible says, in verse 7 through, oh, thank you, praise God, let there be light. No, that's the wrong verse. The Bible says, in verse 7, it says, keep on asking and you will receive what you ask for. Keep on seeking and you will find. Keep on knocking and the door will be open to you. For everyone who asks, receives. Everyone who seeks, finds. And everyone who knocks, the door will be open to you. It goes on to say, you parents, if your children ask for a loaf of bread, do you give them a stone instead? It's kind of weird. And if they ask for a fish, do you give them a snake? Of course not. So if you sinful people, if we sinful people know how to give good gifts to our children, how much more will your Heavenly Father give good gifts to those who ask Him? It's right ask for, we can receive. Anything we ask for in his name. Now, the first time I read that, I'm not going to lie, when I got saved, I was an atheist. I hated God. I did drugs, slept around, I did crazy stuff. But when I got saved, you know, everybody gets saved, they read the New Testament. That's like the thing, you know. Like, oh, start in Matthew and just, you know, fill it up. And so I read that, and I was like, Lamborghini in Jesus' name. I started asking myself, I was like, Lord, I want some free Burger King. But no, the point of this verse, it says ask first, but then it says keep seeking and you will find.
That's right.
Keep seeking, you will find. Keep knocking and the door will be open to you. The point of that is, I believe that, you know, Jesus is alive. I think a lot of us believe that. That's real.
Yeah.
If you haven't, you should ask me. And you know, it's like 5-minute prayer and a lifestyle away. So that keep asking and you will receive. Keep seeking and you will find. Keep knocking and the door will be open to you. So Jesus is here. He's everywhere, you know, but he's with us. And that implies that if we ask, we seek, and we knock. The only way that we can ask is if we believe that there's going to be an answer. You know, if I were to go over here and ask this wall to give me a piece of bread, what's going to happen? Nothing. Because it's a wall, you know. But if I ask a person, hey, how you doing? Or, hey, can you give me this? Can you help me with this? Jesus is a person. He's alive today.
Right.
It's the same going with seeking. You're seeking the person, Jesus.
Yeah.
You're seeking the things and the lifestyle. It goes on to say that greater things that we will do on this earth.
Yeah.
There's a great study on it. Todd White talks about it, but it's the reason that there are greater things is because we have Holy Spirit in us.
Yeah.
If you don't know about Holy Spirit, come ask me. It's a 5-minute prayer and a lifestyle away. But come on. So, and then keep knocking and that door will be open to you. The only way you can knock at a door, when I go over to my friend's house and I knock on the door, I believe and I hope that he's on the other side.
Yeah.
And if he's not, I walk away. But the great thing about this, it says keep knocking and the door will be open. It doesn't matter if you believe that he's on the other side. The door will be open to you. So anything we ask for, we will receive. Anything. Anything. The man, when we seek it, we will find. In humility, in my little, like, faith, it was what, I think, I was only saved for like a year, and I prayed. I was like, God, man, I'm reading these cool things in the Bible, these visions, these dreams. It'd be really cool to have that. It'd be really cool to dream some dreams, you know? And then later on, I started reading, I'm like, man, so that worked. I started getting dreams. And later on, I was like, man, it'd be really cool to pray for people that were sick and see them healed.
Yeah.
It has nothing to do with me, but it was my willingness to be those hands and feet.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not a great person. I'm just Nate. But I'm willing. I'm in love with Jesus, and I've seen him move in ways that I've never seen before. The most recent one was, I was telling Shane a little bit about it. I was like, man, you see all these people like delivering, you know, demons. And I was like, man, God, that'd be really cool. And then he put one in front of me. I was scared to death. I was scared. I said, Lord Jesus. I texted my friend. I said, hey, can you come help me? He said, no, you got it. I was like, Jesus. But no glory to me. I was just willing. I thought it would be cool. Dare to pray the cool prayers. You know? No matter who you are, no matter what you do, dare to believe the cool things. Because everything in here is cool. That's all I gotta say. I just wanted to. Done are the days. Gone are the days that we come to these things and wait to just receive marching orders. It has nothing to do with the people that are up here. I think we've said that 19 times tonight. It has nothing to do with us. It has nothing to do with a barn full of believers. It has to do with what you do with tonight. What you do with moments like this. If we were to go every, it'd be really unhealthy
if you were to go every single day or every single week of your life and only eat one day? You'd be really unhealthy and you'd probably die. But we're not meant to just come get fed here, like at a moment like this. We're meant to get fed here on a day-to-day basis. Take it a verse at a time if you have to. We're meant to be fed by this and go out and do the things that it says. Go into all the world and preach the gospel. It starts right here. It starts right here.
We're playing a musical microphone right now. So while we were still worshiping, I was standing back there by Michelle. And Shane was talking about how if you're a believer, if you see visions, we raised our hands. Or we prophesied and we raised our hands. At that moment, God was clearly showing me in this room tonight, while we're worshiping, there's going to be prayer cells. Going to happen. If you want to know why you're not empowered, you want to know why you're not living a powerful life, it's because you're not praying enough. You can take that to the bank. If you want to know why you're not walking in power, you want to know why you can't get over the things you've been wanting to get over for years and years and years, because you're not praying, you're not getting on your knees. You're not asking the people in your community to pray for you. You're not actually letting down the shame that has held you so captive. It is time to let go.
Yep.
It is time to get on your knees. It is time for you to start praying.
Yeah.
It is time for you to start asking the family of faith that you're in, whether it's this one or the one across the street or the one across town. It is time for us to start activating our faith in a prayer-filled life. It's been said before. I was just waiting for all of this. Every single thing from Shane to Mondo to Nate. It is all part of the godly order of what's happening tonight. If you're familiar with fire and fragrance, we got the fire, now we need the fragrance. We need the fragrance, which is the prayer of the saints. It fills the incense, that's what it says in Revelation. If you want to know how to fill up those incense bowls, if you want to see God pour out power upon your life, if you want those things to finally come to pass that you've been hoping for and waiting for your entire life, start tonight.
Yes.
Start tonight.
Yes.
Get in some people that you know more than five. Start getting in some groups. Start praying for one another. If you need healing, start praying for it. Start activating your faith. Start saying, God, I believe. Just like Nate did. Man, it would be cool if I could cast out a demon. Come on. And it happened. God gave him the opportunity because he activated his faith. He wasn't afraid. He wasn't afraid of what it might look like. He wasn't afraid of what it might feel like. He wasn't afraid. So they're going to continue playing. They're going to just build it up, build it down, let the Holy Spirit take them. We don't know what's going on. They're the fire. The prayer is the fragrance. We're going to dim the lights. I want no more than five people in a group. Start turning around. If you don't know anybody, get out of your comfort zone. Start praying for people around you. This is the family of faith.
Yes.
If you're afraid of telling somebody your issues, guess what? You may not ever see them again. But the thing that you ask them to pray for might stick with them, and they're going to be the family of faith you know you never had.
That's right.
So let's go. Turn off the lights.
Start turning around.
Let's start activating our faith. Let's
start praying. Introduce yourselves if they want. Start praying.
God is going to do something big right now.
Thank you.
so now that you know each other in your groups, let's do something. We're going to pray a specific style of prayer. Us sugar writers, we call it Korean style. If you've never heard a Korean pray, get to know one. They love Jesus. And so, Korean style is just everybody out loud at the same time, because God is big and he has big enough ears and he can hear all of us at the same time. So, but I just really feel like something big. We're on the verge of something big. So let's cry out all together in our groups, in your own words, whatever it is. Cry out for the glory of God to fall in this place. Cry out, just pray out the glory of God to fall in this place. All right? Ready? One, two, three, go.
God, we just cry out to you, God. We want you, God. We want down to this place, God. We want God.
Thank you. Thank you.
praise your name, Jesus. Hey, I think we're good. But God ain't done. If you need prayer or anything, we're going to chill for a little bit. Pray from us or anybody in this room, honestly. Or if you want to just chat, find out what's been going on. My wife and I are still missionaries. We got a lot of stories. Thank you guys for having us.
If you enjoyed this message today, be sure to like and subscribe. For more messages or to get plugged in, visit FridayNightLight.us.